Defense Updates has reached more than 150,000 subscribers. We're genuinely thankful to our viewers. You keep us going. We don't dilute your video watching experience in this channel with sponsored products. If you like what we're doing, kindly support us on Patreon. www.patreon.com/defenseupdates. Japanese Minister of Defense Itsunori Onodera announced on the 8th of December that Tokyo plans to equip Japan Air Self-Defense Force JASDF fighter aircraft with long-range cruise missiles amid heightened tensions in the region over North Korea's development and testing of nuclear weapons and ballistic missiles. Onodera said in a press conference that Japan would acquire the missiles under the budget for fiscal year 2018, FY2018. To enhance the country's defense capabilities in view of an increasingly severe security environment, adding that Tokyo will still rely on the United States to strike enemy bases. The sources said the government is especially interested in Lockheed Martin Corp's JASSM-ER long-range air-to-ground missile. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why US-made JASSM-ER is the perfect weapon for Japan to deal with North Korean missiles.
Number 5.
North Korea has hurled multiple threats against Japan. In September, a North Korean state agency threatened to use nuclear weapons to sink Japan and reduce the United States to ashes and darkness for supporting a UN Security Council resolution and sanctions over its latest nuclear test. Korea Air Pacific Peace Committee, which handles the North external ties and propaganda, said in a statement carried by the North's official KCNA news agency, "The four islands of the archipelago should be sunken into the sea by the nuclear bomb of Juche. Japan is no longer needed to exist near us." In October, North Korea has issued a chilling warning to Japan to stop putting pressure on Kim Jong-un to relinquish his nuclear program. Japan's such rackets inciting the tension of the Korean Peninsula is a suicidal deed that will bring nuclear clouds to the Japanese archipelago, the statement read. No one knows when the touch-and-go situation will lead to a nuclear war, but if so, the Japanese archipelago will be engulfed in flames in a moment. This is too self-evident.
Number 4.
Japan is a pacifist country, at least according to its constitution. Article 9, introduced under the occupying forces after the Second World War, seems unequivocal. The Japanese people forever renounce war and the threat or use of force. But new laws introduced by conservative Prime Minister Shinzo Abe will allow a broader interpretation of what the constitution does and does not permit, so-called proactive pacifism. The move may stir controversy in Japan, which upholds an exclusively defense-oriented policy under the war-renouncing constitution, since the missiles would be capable of striking enemy bases. Opponents say the laws are war bills, and tens of thousands of people have taken to the streets to protest against the legislation. But some commentators argue Japan needs it, keeping in view the North Korean as well as Chinese threats. Japan Prime Minister Abe has reiterated his determination to use the crushing majority he now enjoys to remove from Japan's constitution provisions which restrict his ability to deploy or use military force.
Number 3.
Short, intermediate, as well as long-range missile of North Korea, which includes Nodong-1, Hwasong-12, Hwasong-14, and latest Hwasong-15 are transported on a transporter erector vehicle, TEL, but launched from a detachable platform on a concrete pad. Hence, the missile are dependent on pre-assigned sites for launch and are vulnerable against preemptive strikes. North Korea currently doesn't have these missiles in hardened silos, so even a modest strike could disable its launch. North Korean threats have meant it's in constant surveillance by the US, South Korea, and Japan. The assets include satellites, land-based radar network, and reconnaissance aircrafts. North Korean missile program is still not mature. Impending launches need elaborate organizational work and are detected as the missile is made ready for it.
Number 2.
JASSM-ER, Joint Air-to-Surface Standoff Missile Extender Range, is a variant of AGM-158 JASSM. The JASSM-ER is a low-observable standoff air-launched cruise missile developed in the United States. It's a large, stealthy, long-range weapon of the 2,000 pounds class. The missile has an official range of 1,000 kilometers or 620 miles. It's powered by a turbofan engine, which enables it to travel at Mach 0.8 to 0.9, or about 1,000 kilometers per hour. The JASSM-ER has 70% hardware commonality and 95% software commonality with the original AGM-158 JASSM. The first flight test of the JASSM-ER occurred on May 18, 2006, when a missile was launched from a U.S. Air Force B-1 bomber at the White Sands Missile Range in New Mexico. The JASSM-ER entered service with the USAF in April 2014.
Number 1.
The features of the missile are as follows. 1. JASSM-ER utilizes a low observable airframe designed to defeat enemy air defenses. The missile's low profile airframe is particularly important given the proliferation of sophisticated air defenses. 2. The missile is guided by INS/GPS unit developed for the JDAM and JSOW bombs, and uses IR seeker for terminal guidance. It also incorporates three-dimensional targeting models of the intended targets, of which 8 can be stored in each missile. The missile is accurate within 3 meters CEP. 3. The JASSM-ER weapon can be employed day or night in adverse weather conditions. 4. It can be fitted with different 1,000-pound warheads according to the mission profile. Most of the North's weapons of mass destruction production units and storage facilities are located in the mountainous areas near the Russian and Chinese borders. Due to distance, Japan needs a standoff missile with precision strike capabilities. With JASSM-ER, Japan has a way to take out these positions without ever needing to enter the North Korean airspace. North Korea has very little chance of detecting this missile with its old radar tech and will find it impossible to intercept.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.